Scott, and welcome back to another video with Credit Hint LLC. Today what I want to do is I want to actually answer a question that was raised by one of our credit handling customers in regards to validation. The reason I'm actually raising this issue up is because the client, they contacted me and they said, hey, I actually had an account. This particular account was actually charged off with the original creditor. I've been trying to reach out to them to go ahead and make the payment so I can go ahead and get it removed. However, they're not even responding to me. How can I, I try to reach out to them via mail, also phone call, but yet they don't seem as though that they don't want to do business with me. So what can I do? How can I actually follow up with them? Now, the first thing I will say is I never actually recommend that a person admits that the debt belongs to them. If that's what you want to do, then by all means do it, but there's a certain way that you actually want to do it, and I actually talk about that in another video. However, if they're not actually responding to you, that's actually good for you. And the reason why is because according to the Fair Debt Collection Practices Act, the creditor and the collection agency actually have 14 days to respond to you. And if they don't respond to you, then you can actually litigate the situation or you can actually get it removed from your credit report. Now, what I have suggested to the individual is, well, you have contacted that particular company, you have admitted that the debt belongs to you. But however, what you should do is that in our Ruby Credit Healing Packet, and if you want us to do it for you, we can do that as well. But our Ruby Credit Healing Packet are actually validation letters. And with these particular letters, you're going to actually request for an itemized list of things that they say actually belong to you. So, and you'll see that when you actually open up the packet. However, if they're not responding to you and you request for validation of this particular debt, they have 14 days to respond. So when you send these letters out to the collection agency or to the creditor, if the particular account is charged off but they have the internal collection agency, what you're going to do is that you're going to request validation. And if they do not respond within the 14 days, but let me say this, now when you actually send the letter off, you send it off via certified mail, but you also have to do a return receipt. So you want to have a return receipt, therefore you have proof that if they received it, if they do not find it, then that's on them, that's not on you. So if they do not respond within a 14 day time frame, then what you're going to do is that then you're going to use the follow-up letters that are in the packet. You're going to send this to the credit bureau saying that I have kept a perfect record, and the letter's actually already in there, but I have kept a perfect record of what I have requested from this particular creditor or collection agency, and yet they have not responded to my request. Therefore, per these laws, which is already in the packet, per these laws, this must be removed from my credit report. Now, please remove from my credit report as the federal law states, or I will actually basically move on to the next level, and then we're going to actually file a lawsuit against you, because you can actually do that and you'll win with no problem. The reason why they're actually able to get over on most people is because most people do not know the laws. They do not know the federal guidelines, so it's very easy for them to be able to say, okay, well, we're just going to ignore them, or that we're just not going to follow these things because they're not going to do anything anyway. Now, if you actually mean what you say and you show them that you're very serious, they will actually bow down, because it's really the federal laws that they must bow down to, or they can actually go out of business or be sued for a lot of money, and they don't really want that. So basically what you're going to do is that after you request for validation, then you're going to follow up with the credit bureaus. You follow up with the credit bureaus, then you're going to actually show that as proof that you have done what was actually required per the Fair Credit Reporting Act and the Fair Debt Collection Practices Act, and then you are supposed to get that thing removed. All right, it's actually very easy, but you have to know what you're actually supposed to do. So if you have any questions, please contact me at credithealing@gmail.com, or you can actually call me at 225-733-6429. And if you're ready to get started, please go to www.credithealing.org.